Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure for me to be here. In a way, I'm a kind of naughty boy between the speakers because I do not have to present slides. I think it's better to have a speech for what I want to say to you. It's effectively in CCR something special about the French market, because the French market has on NatCat a specific regime, which French NatCat regime, which is has been set up in 1982, and which is in a way a partnership between the state, between the insurance companies, and of course between with CCR as a cornerstone. In 1982, there was a massive flood in France. Lots of people were not insured against NatCat. They were insured for their homeowners policy, but not within NatCat. And so the penetration rate on the homeowners at that time were quite high, above 90%. And to solve this problem of not being insured for NatCat, but being insured against freeze or whatsoever, fire, it has been implemented an obligation to have an extension, NatCat extension cover, within those policies that were not mandatory, but were fully taken by the citizens. And so this has, in one go, put penetration rate for NatCat cover across the country, and with a specific thing, which was insurance with a regulated rate, the same for everybody, the 12% that is now of the overall premium, which is for NatCat. You have on the insurance also deductible regulated, in order to have a kind of availability of the same type of product to everyone. And you, from this insurance side, have also a prevention side, which is important as a tool for the state in order to make prevention measures against the consequences of NatCat and particularly flood at the time. This was done in a way that within the NatCat premium, there is a kind of tax that goes to a fund, public fund, which is fully dedicated for prevention measures. So this is really something that effectively has more than 30 years of existence, and a system which is built is not built perfectly from scratch at the beginning. And so we also have had to focus on improvements, and improvements have been made, including the incorporation of new perils. At the beginning, it was done for flood mainly, and also earthquakes. But then after, we had to put in the perils the subsidence factor, the houses that were cracked down because of subsidence and the soil, the soil with humidity and drought, which was something very difficult to cope for the government and for the people that were that didn't have any insurance against that. And you also have had improvement on overseas territories, French territories, with cyclones, and cyclones above a certain threshold were incorporated in the NatCat system, with some effect, for example, last year with the Irma, which hit two islands, Saint-Martin and Saint-Barthélemy. The specificity of that was also what is insured, what is insurable, and what is not insurable. And so in the laws that put that in place, you have the term uninsurable that is often mentioned, but it should be taken as a meaning, a specific meaning, uninsurable in the way that the government and the parliament want to make insurance for Nat Cat available for all. And so this is quite a big distinction, and that in a way explains this unique rate of 12% that is taken for the Nat Cat premium, 12% of the property premium. This is effectively not fully actuarial, but this 12% has been calculated and decided, depending of the experience, of course, and depending of the possibilities of future events. It was in 1982. We didn't have any model. We didn't have so many data. This has increased the capabilities of the systems. Now we have made a lot of progress, of course, and it's something that we have to continue, but this uninsurable meaning has changed in a way to be more insurable on an actuarial way. And so we have a move between some perils and also some actors that can fill a gap which from uninsurable becomes insurable, and then it's something that we have to take into account in order to make the inventivity and the possible needs and supply from the market available also for the citizens. So I think that still in France, what is very important is to have the affordability and not to have part of the population that are not insured at all because the areas are so flood prone or earthquakes or whatsoever. And I think that even now, the government and the new government wants to have this in mind. But there is improvements to be made, and this year there is lots of groups with us, CCR, but also different ministries, of course the Treasury, but also the Ecological Ministry of Ecology. We are discussing about some improvement. What improvements? So basic questions for us is, what is the level of acceptance of the risk collectively? and then it comes with the progress of the data and the progress of the models, and we discuss with return period concepts in order to see if where should we intervene, where the market should intervene, and what is acceptable for the people in order to have the feeling of being protected, but also the feeling of being responsible. and if it's not correct, when you have early warnings, when you have knowledge that flood is coming, that you have on your basement many things, and that you effectively with some effort have to take them very easily on the first floor, for example, and you do not do that, there is a problem of responsibility, and it's something that we have to improve also. So it means the risk awareness and the responsibility and the prevention are really areas where we could increase the benefit of the system we have at the moment. So it's type of return period where above 30 years period could be the state intervention. Below, you have some kind of attritional, of course, but also some extreme. So then you can effectively have the CCR, but also there is capacity on the reinsurance market which could be used, and it will be too sad not to use it, especially when it can offer some special price, I would say. And then after, you also have the responsibility of the people, the responsibility of the actors, and the prevention measure. It's also for municipalities, it's also for companies, and also, of course, for individuals and homeowners. So risk awareness is very important. That's specific measures will be taken on that in order to focus again against this memory lost, I would say. Memory loss, why? Because before, we were not moving so fast here and there, and the people that were living in a region know by far that it was not good to build here because of the flood, possible flood, and this information that is were passed generation by generation is not anymore there. And you have also land using planning from municipalities also, who wants to have more inhabitants, and then there is a kind of memory lost also from the local responsible. So what we need to put in place better is in France prevention that is still local, but also very much driven on the global side, and that's where modelization and data and risk awareness are something, a tool from insurance industry that comes into the prevention industry with cost benefit analysis, with the money spending from the state or from budget like public funds that I talked about before could be used more wisely. Crisis management is also something very important. We have seen that in the different moment, and in France we made a lot of progress in crisis management and also in prevention measures. Also after Xynthia, which was a storm with a storm surge, and which have made loss of lives, lots of claims, and this has been something where budgets have increased and made a lot of thing. Land use planning is something that is difficult for industry, in insurance industry, to take care of. So it's typically the act of course, the state and the municipalities. But it is very, very important, the land use planning, because we see a movement of population in areas that effectively are very beautiful, but also very dangerous. And the future risks after that are coming after that we do not fully know yet because of climate change and so on, are on those zones as well. And so there is a big movement in responsibility also on the long use planning. What can the industry do on that? I said risk awareness, prevention, cost-benefit analysis, crisis management, are tools that could be provided by insurance industry as well. Insurance industry is not just indemnification. It's now a service that is provided, and it's not only for NatCat, it's also more general. It's not only indemnification, it's also avoiding a claim, and the client has its claim avoided, and it's a service. And if a claim arises, there is a crisis management in order to limit it. And so you have the value of chain of insurance industry is changing from a just indemnification concept into an overall service, which is also avoiding the claim and avoiding the too expensive costs. I think that we've seen that the market is very helpful in providing new tools, in providing new products. We discussed and we've seen index-based products, for example, which are very helpful because they could even be taken with the mobile, and the mobile wherever you are, and even in small regions or isolated region, you still now can have access to that. And it's a way to deliver a service which is very helpful, which could be very simple, and also for micro insurance, and not only for property NatCat, but also for agriculture risks as well. so yeah, I believe very much in this new products, services, which also could be seen as an added product to existing already product instead of replacing a traditional product. Climate change is something that we see in Paris. We had 2 years ago the COP21, and CCR did a study about the view that we had in 2050. It's long, but not so long. In fact, using the scenario 4.5, which were the scenario compatible with the goal of the COP21 with a maximum plus 2 degrees at the end of the century, we did that study in order to say, well, what are the costs in 2050? And it's a double of the cost that we have in fact calculated using also partnerships with Météo France. And what was interesting and very interesting is that 80% of this increase was due to the sum insured. The sum insured and the movement of population in areas that are more prone to risks. And so that's where I think that land use planning is very, very important. And that's why I strongly believe that all the solutions that we are talking about, especially for the gap insurance, are collective. It's really through partnerships, public-private partnerships. Land use planning cannot be done by private. It can be done by public, helped by private. So that's where I think we have strong ways to build PPPs in the future in other countries than France. And 80% insured value, but 20% climate factors. For France, mostly was due to flood, but also sea level. But with this scenario, sea level was not so dramatic. still manageable. So that's interesting, but we will do a study publishing it at the in June this year, not with the scenario 4.5, in which we do not believe anymore, but with a scenario which at the time COP21 was done, was seen as pessimistic, but we think now that it is the one that is realistic. And so all the computers are with some wave of heat at the moment in Météo France and in CCR and in also the cloud, but which doesn't help the, the climate. but there will be differences in the results, of course. I expect the sea level factor much higher than it is, than it was seen before. In France, we have experienced strong storms in 2015, and in some areas we have seen that there was 60 meters of the coastline that has been taken by the sea, and which put some strong difficulties on the public sector and the private sector, but at the moment not so much the private sector, because all those losses are not insured by the insurance industry, and in some specific circumstances are not indemnified neither by the state. And so you have some couple of cases where you have people that have lost what they had. It's a real problem. Coastline is one of the main topics I have in mind for French coast, but also for some of the biggest cities in the world, because it has a real strong impact on the coast. So we are talking about reducing the insurance gap at the moment. I have to say that there will always be gaps, and also for having a responsibility in mind and not having the feeling of whatever you do or don't do, you will be protected, it's important to have a gap. But there is enormous sectors where you can improve and have insurance where at the moment there is no insurance. Question about that is insurance is payable, and what is the affordability of what is not insured due to difficulties for paying not a claim but for paying a premium. So how to react to limit the gap? I think that the concept of minimum cover, basic cover for almost all, which is the sense for the French system, but it's also the same in Romania, is very important. So voluntary or obligatory, I think it's something that sometimes is difficult for everybody to understand that it is mandatory, and when it is mandatory, it is assumed to be tax, and nobody likes to pay tax, but it's a problem. I may just have an analogy with health insurance for employees in companies, and in fact, health insurance is given, or extra health insurance is given by companies to their employees. And so companies pay premium for that, and the employees receive the compensation. In terms of risk management, I strongly believe that it's very important to have local risk management. Why not having the analogy of companies with municipalities? And municipalities collect as companies, paying claim against NatCat for their inhabitants, pay less premiums, for example, if prevention measures are taken, and also with acceptable and fully responsible land use planning. Sometimes and very often, municipalities have and receive from the state subsidies. So it will be a kind of condition of the good introduction of measures like that in terms of system for the NatCat to their inhabitants from municipalities, well management, and then subsidies from the state depending of this type of level of quality that has been done. It is something that is maybe a solution. It's it avoids the direct access to the customer from insurance market, and the insurance market access the municipalities market, municipalities responsible that then delivers the cover for their inhabitants. Above the basic cover, of course, there is a full extent of the market and the extra cover for all, accessible or available, if they can pay for it, of course, and that has a cost, and that's his and will always be a case. So that's one part of the solution to reduce, I think, the gap. There is also other solutions, of course, which may be directly help governments and not an aftershock, or it's better to have before the shock. Aftershock, usually they can have bonds, but the rates will increase. And so I think that I like the concept of refined insurance, reinsurance, financial and insurance markets can provide to governments tools and products that are clear, easy to understand, easy to manipulate for all the administrative networks that we all have in our countries, through thresholds, through models, through indexes. I think that it will allow governments to have a kind of NatCat risk premium incorporated in their budget, instead of letting things happening and aftershock having to react in order to reduce the consequences of natural catastrophe on their economy. Well, thank you very much. I have finished my